In this video, we're going to talk about how to visualize data. In particular, we're going to use something called a stem and leaf plot. And what's useful about this is it essentially allows you to show all of your data and show a lot of detail about all of the numbers in your data set, while at the same time having a good sense about how those numbers in your set are distributed. Right here, I have a set of numbers. And when I just look at this, it really doesn't make a lot of sense to me. It's just a bunch of numbers to me. I have no sense, are more of them closer to 20 or 30, or more of them closer to 80, or is there median or their mode 30 or 40 or 84? I have no idea. Just looking at this list of numbers. But using a stem and leaf plot, hopefully some of this will become a little bit more apparent. And the idea here is to list kind of the most significant digit in each of those numbers in the stem. So when we talk about the most significant digit, these numbers right here, they range, let's see, we have a number that we have a 2 here, that looks like, we have a 1, that looks like our lowest number. And it goes all the way up to, looks like it goes all the way up to 84. And it has a bunch of numbers in between, in the teens, and the 20s, and the 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, so on and so forth. So it looks like the most significant digit here is the tens digit. So let's write it right here. Let's write our tens digit. Tens digit. And the tens digit could be a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me write this a little bit bigger. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or, let me scroll down a little bit, or an 8. Or an 8. These digits will represent our stem. So I'm going to draw this little line around here. This is going to be our stem right there. That right there is our stem in the stem and leaf, in the stem and leaf plot. For a number like 1, the tenth digit is 0. You can imagine it is 0, 1. For a number like 84, the tenth digit is obviously 8. So what I'm going to do is rewrite all of these numbers here, but I'm going to use it using the stem and leaf plot. And the technique here, and I'm just going to show you by example. Let's go through each of these numbers. Let's say I want to write 35. So 35, let me cross it out. 35, so it has a tens digit of 3. I'll put a 5 right here. That tells me that 35 is one of my numbers. Then I have 42. Cross it out. Let me know I used it. 42. I'm writing the ones digit as leaves. You're going to see what I'm going to do. Let's see, 38. Well, I have a 30. I'm going to write an 8 here. So I didn't have to rewrite the 30. I'm just saying, look, I have a 35, and I have a 38. I'm just writing the ones digits within the 3 stem, within the tens place, within the 30s place, however you want to view it, the 30s bucket. Then we have a 57. 57. We have a 2, which is you could view as a 0, 2. We have a 2. We have 24, 24, 27, 27, 36, 36. We have a 35, a 38, and a 36. 45, 45, 60. I think you get the idea, but just for the sake of completion, let's finish all of these. 38. 38, 40, another 40, a 44, a 44, a 1, a 1, a 4, another 44, a 48. So a lot of things in this 40s bucket. 48, an 84, 84, a 38, 38, a 20. So 20, 20, a 4, put that right there, 0, 4, a 2. It's getting a little monotonous, but let's just finish it. 48, 48, another 48 right there, a 58, 58, a 3, stick it up there, it's 0, 3. And then we have a 20, a 6, a 40, 40. 22, 22, 26, 26, 17, 1, 7. That's our first number in the teens bucket, an 18, 18, a 40, 40, a lot of things in the 40s, a 51, 51, 62, 31, 31, 27, 27, 48, 48, 35, 35, almost done, 27, 37, 58, 58, and 21. And we have our 21. And just like that, it was a little monotonous, but we essentially just rewrote this list of numbers down here. I have every number represented. We haven't lost any information here. I know every number. I could go start with this, and I could list tell you every number that I had in my original list. I have a 6, I have a 27, I have a 38, a 35. So we haven't lost any information. But what's neater about this representation is when the numbers are written this way, we actually save ink, because you don't have to rewrite the 40 to 45. You just write the ones digit. But more importantly, we kind of understand how the numbers are distributed, that we have a bunch of numbers in the 40s and 30s and 20s. That's where most of the numbers are. We have very few numbers up in the 80s, and we have no numbers in the 70s. We have very few. We have a lot in the ones, but still most of them are focused in this range over here. So this is just one of many, many, many ways to visualize data that you will run into in your mathematical or statistical futures, but I just wanted to expose you to this.